Welcome to Gethsemane Baptist Temple, the voice of Calvary. Located in Star, South Carolina, we are a lively, old-time, Bible-believing, camp-meeting-style church where the shout has not died out. Join us now as our pastor, Sam Duncan, brings this week's message.
I dreamed of a city called glory, so bright and so fair. When I entered the gates, I cried, "Holy, the angels all met me there. They carried me from mansion to mansion, and all the sights I saw. But I said, I want to see Jesus, the one who died for all. I bowed on my knees and cried, city. My loved ones all knew me well. They took me down the streets of heaven. All the saints, too many to tell, I saw Abraham, Jacob, and Isaac, spoke with Mark, sat down with Timothy. Oh, yeah. But I said, Timothy, I want to see Jesus, for he's the
I'm on my knees and cry. Light. Darkness. Good. Evil. Truth. Lies. We are engaged in an epic battle between two spiritual kingdoms for the hearts and minds of our youth. Every day, our kids are bombarded with lies about who they are, who their creator is, what is right, and where their salvation comes from. But we are not meant to fight this battle alone. God, the ruler of the good kingdom, has given his kingdom keepers spiritual armor to wear. With this VBS, your kids will learn how they can be a part of God's kingdom through salvation in his son, and they will be equipped with the armor of God as they train to become keepers of the kingdom who stand strong in today's battle for truth. Huzzah!
All right, we're going to do things totally different this morning. Like we did earlier, I'm going to ask all of the ladies in the house, all the females, whether you're a mother yet or not, doesn't matter. I'm going to ask all the ladies across the building to stand. I'm going to read my text sitting down, because I ain't going to be the only one standing with a bunch of ladies. And I'm going to save you some work. Now, don't get used to this. I like it when you got your Bible with you. But this morning I've got two texts of two different mothers. One's in the Old Testament and the other's in the New. And it would have you going every few seconds. So I've got both opening texts in the computer. Pop them up, please. I'm going to sit down. Listen to this. He also walked in the ways of the house of Ahab. Why did he live such a terrible life? For his mother. Listen to this. For his mother was his counselor to do wickedly. Now, I believe anything that's in the Bible, but that's almost unbelievable. But it's true. He walked in the ways of the house of Ahab, for his mother was his counselor to do wickedly. But it does not have to be that way. Pop up the next text. Paul, writing to Timothy, says, when I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois, and then in thy mother Eunice, Paul said, I'm persuaded that it's in thee also. I'm going to stand up. You got one mama over here, whether she did it by lecturing and by words or if it was by example, the Bible did not say. But it did say that that woman led her son to follow wicked ways. God help us to not have any mothers here that would want to lead their children down the path of wrong. But then on this side over here, the Apostle Paul said, writing to Timothy, he said, Timothy, I see that unfeigned faith that is in thee. The word feign means fake. Unfeigned would mean unfake, or as we would say, true and real. Paul is saying, when I look at that true and real faith that's in you. He said, I know how you got it. He said, it was in your grandma first. Grandma lived a holy life. Grandma passed it on down to her daughter, which was Eunice, that eventually became Timothy's mother. So now you got grandma serving God. You got mama serving God. And down here on the bottom rung, you got Timothy serving God. I want to preach a little bit on Mother's Day on the power of influence. While you're standing, ladies, you can influence your children to do right. Or you can influence your children to end up like they're living in the house of Ahab. You do remember Ahab and Jezebel, the most wicked couple in the Bible. Somebody say amen. And this young man followed those ways because of all things mama wasn't true to God. And she led him down the wrong path. The power of influence. So let's pray, and then all you dear ladies can be seated. Our Father God, we thank you today for the privilege of being in the house of God on this Mother's Day. And Lord, would many of us, our mamas are in the glory world, but Lord, we do thank you for the influence that they had on us. And Lord, many of us are saved today. Many of us are in church today. Many of us are serving you today because it was passed down through a family heritage of godly women. And I pray that, Lord, you'd fill every woman here today with a strong sense of responsibility, and let them do right for themselves. But if they won't do right for themselves, let them do it for their children and their grandchildren. God, let me, I pray, have the anointing and the power and the touch of God upon me today. Lord, I want to be respectful to these ladies, but at the same time, I want to preach truth. Have your will and way. We pray it, Father, and we do ask it all in Jesus' mighty name. And all you godly ladies loudly said what? I believe y'all did better than the men. Ladies, thank you, and you may be seated. Let me begin this morning by saying, in this world that we live in, there are all kinds of powers. Let me say, first of all, there's electric power. You use it in every home represented here. There's lights and a refrigerator and air conditioning, and we all rely on electric power. But that's not all. You go out here and get in your vehicle, put that key in the switch and turn it over. You're going to rely on the horsepower of that engine to take you back home. So there's electric power and there's horsepower, and then there's the big one, nuclear power. But let me say to you today, the strongest power on the face of God's earth is a godly mother. Let me tell you, that young person might not quit drinking because daddy's whipped him with a belt. That young person might not get off drugs because daddy's threatened to cut off the money. But let me tell you, when mama goes to crying and mama goes to praying and mama gets in touch with God, I don't care how hard your heart is, it will touch the heart of even the most wicked, ungodly person. Would somebody put an amen right there. Oh, listen to me. God help these young people today that do not have godly mothers. Let me say, life is hard. Life is tough. Temptations everywhere. Drugs, alcohol, immorality, you name it. It's there. But boy, if you got a godly mother sitting in the house of God with you this morning, you got a mama that knows how to pray. You got a mother that opens up that book and tells you what thus saith the Lord. You got a chance in life of making it. Somebody say something. I want to thank God today that I had an old-fashioned praying mama. What, it was not ashamed of Jesus. Let me say, we've got somehow to get it in the mind of the young women that become mothers to understand the power that they have through their influence. Boy, when mama cheats on daddy, when mama has no use for God, when mama never prays, when mama never opens a Bible, when that young person has no recollection or memory of mama going to the house of God, one of these days there'll be no attachment to the heartstring. But boy, if you had a mama that said, boy, get your rear out of bed, I'll take the broom to you if I have to. You get your rear out of that bed and you're going to church. I didn't like it when I was about 14. I didn't like it when I was 16. But I sure say hallelujah to the Lamb of God that I had a mama that recognized the power of influence and influenced me the right way. Mama cannot save you. But let me tell you this. You're well on your way if you got a godly praying mama. But I'm going to say it, in spite of everything, you're at a disadvantage if you don't have a godly mama. I'm the bearer of some bad news. If you don't have a godly mama, you're living life at a disadvantage. Listen to me, young ladies. Maybe your mothers, maybe you've not reached that stage of your life. You need to commit yourself to God and do it now, because one of these days there's going to be a pair of eyes looking up at you. Wait a minute. I'm not finished yet. I just mentioned the young mothers. But now, by the Bible mentioned the grandmothers. Your job's not finished just because your child is 17 years old. Hey, are you listening to me? The Bible said Timothy became the godly man that he did, and it started first with his grandma. Thank God for old-fashioned grandmas that are not ashamed. You didn't see grandma strutting around in a halter and hot pants, cussing and smoking cigarettes and drinking liquor. Somebody say amen. You're talking about somebody that knew how to act, that knew how to live, and could get in touch with God. And then when it gets passed to the next generation, and then when it gets to the next one, you'll say, thank God I had an old-fashioned praying mama that could get mean when she needed to get mean. Hey, I'm hopping ahead of myself. There's a poem. I don't have a copy of it, but I've seen it before. And I'm not a poet, and I can't quote it anyway. But it said something about, I got the meanest mama in town. It said, mama won't let me stay out past 11. Mama won't let me smoke cigarettes. Mama won't let me hang with anybody and everybody I want to. Mama will beat me if she smells booze on my breath. Mama does it and said, I got a mean mama. But then the second paragraph shows up. And now that young person, she said, now that I'm a mama, said, it's my goal that I'll be the meanest mama in town. Woo! See, you won't appreciate it at 14 or 16. But let me tell you, when you get old enough to grow a brain, you'll appreciate somebody that tried to correct you and lead you down the right path of life. Somebody say something. Man, I've given you two examples. I hope you've already decided which one you're going to be. One of them said, I'm going to lead my daughter to the Lord. I'm going to lead my grandson to the Lord. And Timothy became the great man of God that he was. And one of the books of the Bible bears his name because grandma was in the background. Grandma made a difference. Or you can choose to raise your children up to be absolute heathen if that's what you so desire to do. And it'll work because you've got that kind of an influence. The Bible said that one in 2 Chronicles walked in the house of Ahab because his mother told him to do what's wrong. Let me give you just a few quick things this morning and we'll not stay here all day. Number one, I want you to see the influence of a godly mother's faith. Let me say, they might not tell you right now, Mama. They might not say it to you till they get much older. But I got news for you. If you're a mother, you got some eyes looking at you. If you're a grandmother, you still got some eyes looking up at you. They might not tell you, but let me say, they're watching the way you live your life. And they are forming their opinions of life by what they see out of you. A lot of folks are forming the opinion of what they don't want to be like. But hallelujah, some are forming opinions on what they want to be like. Let me say, folks, we need it for us. We need the house of God for us. But we need it because for our children and our grandchildren's sake that they can grow up and hear about God, hear people sing about God, see women up here lifting their hands and shouting about the goodness and the grace and the mercy of God instead of mama drinking booze and living like hell. Somebody say amen. Let me show you the influence of a godly mother. Pop up the next verse. Her name is Hannah. Hannah, and it's recorded here, and she said, "Oh, my Lord, as thy soul liveth, my Lord, I am the woman that stood by thee here praying unto the Lord. For this child I prayed, and the Lord hath given me my petition which I ask of him. Therefore also I have lent him to the Lord. As long as he liveth, he shall be lent to the Lord." And he worshiped the Lord there. Here's Hannah. After some maybe a year, 2 years, 3 years, we don't know, she went back and went to the same spot and began to pray again. She said, "Lord, remember me. Remember me, Lord. I'm the one that stood right here in this very spot. And I prayed that you'd bless me with a child." See, Hannah was a barren woman. And she prayed. And guess what? She has that child. And now God has blessed her. And she goes back. She said, "Lord, I'm the one that came to that altar and prayed for my children." You know what we need today? We need the altars in the house of God full of mamas praying for their children. It still works. Notice what it said. "The Lord hath given me my petition which I ask of him." Hey, let me tell you, nobody's going to pray for you like a godly mama will. The echoes, singing echoes, do that song. "I miss those prayers that you prayed for me. Let me tell you, when mama was here, I still had somebody. Always. They didn't have to be in that room over there, but I had somebody that was always praying for me. Boy, and after mama went on, I may or may not have somebody praying for me. I was blessed with a godly mother. Let me say right now, I challenge every one of you ladies, settle that thing out right now. There's going to be times that your children are going to need prayer. I don't mean to upset you, but there's going to be children grow up and start messing with booze. There are going to be children grow up and begin to play with drugs. They'll probably smoke some of that wacky tobacco. They might end up in jail. I hope not. I pray not. But let me tell you, whatever it is, there's going to be a time your children are going to need prayer. And nobody is going to pray out their heart any more than a godly mother. Now, if she's not a godly mother, you're pretty much on your own. But a godly mother can get through. For this child I prayed, and the Lord hath given me my petition, which I ask of him. Said, because of that, God, I'm just going to lend him to you. She said, God, you can take better care of him than I can anyway. I'm giving him to you. And guess what? That's the next generation. He worshiped the Lord there. Let me say, the greatest thing is to raise up another generation. When they get on their own, they're not doing it because of daddy, they're not doing it because of mama, but they go and worship God because they want to be at the house of God. Oh, hey, we're not through yet. Just pop up that next one. Then Jesus went and departed in the coast of Tyre and Sidon. And behold, a woman of Canaan came out of the same coast and cried unto him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, thou son of David. My daughter is grievously vexed with the devil. Let me tell you, there's a lot of people been vexed of the devil. I'm here to tell you, you ride up to the mall and look around. You go to some of the activities, even at school. You look around among some of the young people today, and you'll find that the devil has grievously vexed a lot of people in this next generation. I'm not trying to upset your Mother's Day. I'm just trying to tell you the truth. Now let's go to the next set of verses that go with it. She came and worshiped him. And then notice down about four lines from the bottom. Jesus answered and said unto her, O woman, great is thy faith. Be it unto thee even as thou wilt. And her daughter, woo! And her daughter was made whole from that very hour. That's what a praying mama can do for you. That's what a praying grandmother can do for you. I'm here to say, young people, you find some praying grandma and you get hooked to her. You hold on to her. If you got a praying mama and a godly mama and one that's living for God, hold on to her. Let me say, when the world kicks you to the curb and they wouldn't spit on you if you were on fire. Let me tell you, young people, hear me. When the world won't give you the time of day, it'll still be that godly grandparent, that godly parent. They'll be there for you through thick or thin. But it's all about godliness. I don't mean to upset anybody, but there's more to being a mama than giving birth. Somebody say amen. It's the way you live and the way you conduct yourself. We're talking the power of influence for righteousness. But notice again, I got to show it again. Here's the power of influence the wrong way. Next verse. He also walked in the ways of the house of Ahab, for his mother was his counselor to do wickedly. Mama ran with a hellacious crowd. Mama probably did ungodly things. And guess what? It produced a boy that walked in the house of Ahab. Wicked as can be because of the power of influence. I'm asking every mother here today, every lady who would be a potential mother, settle that thing out between you and God today. You need to do it for yourself, but for if there's no other reason, those children and those grandchildren, they need a godly mama or a godly grandma in their lives for them to ever make it in this wicked world. Somebody say amen. Number two, let's see not only the influence of a mother's faith, let's see the influence of a mother's family. I've already said it, but nobody will stick by you like a godly mother. And if she won't stick by you, she's not godly. Let me prove it by Scripture. Now there stood by the cross of Jesus, his mother. Mary said, I don't care what they're saying. I don't care what they're doing. I don't care if they come and lock me up. I don't care, Mary said. I don't care if they crucify me. I'm hanging on to that young person that I love. There was Jesus about 33 years old. And guess what? When those big old hairy-chested muscle men disciples ran off and wouldn't take a stand, and when nobody else would, that godly mother is hugging around the foot of the cross. Thank God one more time for godly mothers. Listen to me, mothers. If you have a disrespect for the Bible, it is very likely your children will have a disrespect for the Bible. But hold it. I'm not finished with that statement. Every generation seems to take things further than the previous generation. Hey, I'm old enough. I remember the way it used to be. I would never believe. But we've lost a lot generation by generation. Let me tell you what will be. This generation will take it to the next level downward. If you disrespect the Bible, not only will they disrespect the Bible, they'll probably disrespect the God of the Bible. They'll take it to a whole other level. But mama, listen to me. When you pray and you're faithful to the house of God, you show your children that God is really worth something, that you believe in the power of God and the power of prayer. When they see the love in you, when they see the loyalty in you, and when they see the Lord in you, you will get their attention. So we see the influence of a mother's faith. We see the influence of a mother's family. And thirdly, I want you to see the influence of a mother's faithfulness. Thank God for faithful mothers. Mothers that were faithful to the home. A mama, I'm just going to say it, is faithful to daddy. A mother that's faithful to church. A mother that's faithful to the Word of God. A mother who's really sincere. Pop up. Let's see the next. I read this a while ago, but you got to see it again. He said, when I call to remembrance the unfeigned, which means the real, true faith that's in you. He said, I'm not surprised because it dwelt first in your granny. It was in your grandmother. Then it came on down, it got in your mama, and here it is in you too. You don't know why? Because grandma and mama were faithful. I'm going to be just completely mean right now on Mother's Day. If mama stayed up to 2 a.m. this morning down at Porky's Tavern, that probably, I don't even think it exists anymore. But out carousing and around. And this morning, her intentions might have been to go to Mother's Day service with her children. And they couldn't get up and get out of the bed. At least in the example of faithfulness, Mama failed the test. Or maybe Mama wasn't out at a honky-tonk or a bar. Maybe she was at the house. But nevertheless, could not get motivated from the Lord enough to get up and to make it to the house of God. At least in that area, that mother is teaching unfaithfulness instead of faithfulness. Let me tell you the best. Everybody cannot preach. Everybody cannot teach. Everybody cannot play an instrument. Everybody cannot teach Sunday school. Everybody, but let me tell you, everybody that's saved can be faithful. You just got to make up your mind that you're going to do it. And above all things, let me tell you what American society needs. They need faithful grandmothers. They need faithful mothers if we're going to produce faithful children. Now, I know godly people have suffered because of wayward children. That will happen sometimes. But the odds are so much in your favor for good when you teach them. Does not the Bible say, train up a child in the way he should go, and when he is old, he'll not depart from it. Somebody say amen. Let's stay with me a little bit. Number four, let's see the faithfulness of a mother's future. Her faith, her family, all these things. Let's talk about the influence of a mother's future. Proverbs 31 is the most famous verses about a mother. I've used them many times on Mother's Day, so it wasn't my text this morning. But everybody knows Proverbs 31 was written about a son talking about his mama. And he said, who can find a virtuous woman? For her price is far above rubies. The heart of her husband doth safely trust in her, and she will do him no spoil all the days of her life. But let's skip down to the part that addresses the children and the mother. Pop up. Her children arise up and call her blessed. Wait a minute before we look at the rest of it. Ma'am, don't you want one day your children to say, oh, Mama's really been a blessing in my life? Well, if you want that, you got to lay some groundwork now, because it's not going to just accidentally happen. Notice, her children rise up and call her blessed. Her husband also will praise her. Many daughters have done virtuously, but thou excellest them all. Favor is deceitful, and beauty is vain. But a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. How many of you believe the Bible? There it is. Look, favor's deceitful and beauty's vain. There's nothing wrong with looking nice. Okay? I don't think you got to be homely to be right with God. But what he is saying, that if you put all your emphasis on beauty, you have deceived yourself. You need to be beautiful on the inside. When you got a praying mama that'll get you and pray with you. When you got to pray a mama that'll open up the Word of God in your presence. When a woman that makes it faithfully to the house of God. For a mother, a woman that you see at the altar calling your name out. Then one day that child will rise up and call her blessed. You know, I tried to do it when Mama was still with me. I tried to let her know she was a blessing. But you know, she's been gone since about, I don't know, 2011. And you know what? I'm still talking about what a blessing. And you know what? If I live another 40 or 50 years, I'm still going to be saying I was blessed to have had a mama that would tear me up when I needed it. When I did something wrong, she showed me love by getting me in the right direction. Mama was not a social butterfly. She stayed home, took care of her children. She didn't run all over hell and half of creation, but was in the house of God come Sunday morning and made such an example and impression in my life. I couldn't get away from it if I wanted to. Somebody say something in honor of mama. Hallelujah. Woman that feareth the Lord to be praised, her children rise up. Mama, one of these days you want your children to say, boy, mama sure has been a blessing all my life. If you want that, you got to do something now to earn it. And the last point, and I'm not trying to make anybody sad, we'll talk about the influence of mama's finality. Mama's not always going to be with you. I want to tell you that, you know, the first couple in the Bible, they were a badly dysfunctional family, Adam and Eve. Then they got run out of the garden. But you know what? We never know whatever happened after that. The first family that the Bible talks to us about and gives details, there was a man named Abraham. And Abraham had a wife named Sarah. They had children, Isaac and Jacob. The Bible tells us, listen, so did you know the first cemetery ever mentioned in the Bible was down at a place called Machpelah? Sarah died, and Abraham and those boys went down there and buried mama. Isaac had a tough time. Isaac, the Bible tells us, he suffered because of the loss of his mother. But you got to have some comfort once they're gone. You won't have comfort if they've lived like hell. But if they've lived godly, you can find comfort because you know they're in the presence of God. They didn't die. They just changed houses. They're alive on the other side. And in Genesis 24, it said that Isaac finally was comforted after his mother's death. Mama, you got to live the way that's going to leave behind some comfort and peace. See, if your children are looking up to you and they think, Lord, have mercy, is mama a maniac? What is? But if they say, oh, she's a godly woman, when that day, and I'm not trying to spoil the joy of Mother's Day, but when that day does come, you can look back and take comfort. Because if you're saved, you're going to meet mama again. We're going to be together on the other side. The family be reunited. Listen to me, and I'm winding down. When you were a kid, let me take you back to childhood. Well, some of us, we were playing in the back alley on the mill hill. Some of you were playing out at the barn on the farm. But it was probably mama came out and said, hey, come on in. It's time to eat. Time went by and you grew up. You got out on your own and you were living somewhere else. It's probably mama called you and said, hey, I've not seen you in a few weeks. I wish you'd come by and see me. If it's a godly mother, she ought not have to ask you to go see her. But then let me get to the finality. One of these days, just like my mother did, and like my grandmothers did, and many of you, today with many of us, it's just a memory. Mother's Day. It's all we got. But Mama's final call is not come on in and eat. Mama's final call is not come on in and take a bath. Mama's final call is not come by and visit. Mama's final call is join me in heaven. What in the world would be worth risking, number one, missing heaven? What would be worth risking missing seeing Jesus? And thirdly, what would be worth missing meeting Mama? On the other side, Mama, your children deserve having a praying mama and a godly mother and a mother that'll be sitting beside them in the house of God, making memories of worship, making memories of prayer, because that's what I live on Mother's Day. Which mama are you going to be? Are you going to lead your children toward wickedness? Are you going to have a spiritual heritage like Lois and Eunice and then Timothy? Let's pray. Our Father God, we do thank you for the godly women you placed. In our lives. I thank you, Lord, that had a godly grandmother. Thankful that I had a godly mother. And Lord, we thank you today that we can live on these good, good memories till we meet again on the other side. I pray, God, that for every person that has a godly mother, they'll appreciate them. And I pray that everybody that would hear this message, whether they're here now or might catch it on TV or the internet, I'm asking that every mother have conviction to live right, not only for herself, but for her children, because of the power of influence. And I pray, God, you'd get inside our souls, touch our hearts. We commit it this day on Mother's Day. Pray that some mother might be saved today. Some mother that has been saved but has limped along, they'd step up to the spiritual plate and mean business, realizing that her children deserve having a godly mother. Touch our hearts. We commit it in Jesus' name.
Amazing grace.
Yeah.
of the stave. Let's crank these ladies up.
We hope you have enjoyed this week's broadcast of Gethsemane Baptist Temple, the voice of Calvary. We invite you to join us here each week. Or better yet, join us on Sunday at 6116 Highway 81 South in Star, South Carolina. For more information, visit us online at www.gbtemple.com. We look forward to seeing you in church Sunday.
Good, evil, truth, lies. We are engaged in an epic battle between two spiritual kingdoms for the hearts and minds of our youth. Every day, our kids are bombarded with lies about who they are, who their creator is, what is right, and where their salvation comes from. But we are not meant to fight this battle alone. God, the ruler of the good kingdom, has given his kingdom keepers spiritual armor to wear. With this VBS, your kids will learn how they can be a part of God's kingdom through salvation in his Son, and they will be equipped with the armor of God as they train to become keepers of the kingdom who stand strong in today's battle for truth. Huzzah!